Hello everyone, it's Eddie the Magic Monkey. Welcome to another SQL lesson, and let's open up our select query again. So in the previous lesson we talked about selecting specific rows from the students table, and I want you to save this select query so then we don't have to override it. So let's save it as another, let's copy and paste it so I can have select query 2, and so I have two queries. And let's close our first one and let's just edit the second query. Okay, so what I want to do now is I want to introduce you guys to some special operators that we can use under the WHERE clause. So let's say that I want all the students that are younger than the year 2000. So that's what I have here, born after the 1st of February. Let's just put 1st of January. So let's run that. And these are all the people who were born after the 1st of January in 2000. And let's say I only want to list students who's a female. Okay, so then I'm going to go where birthday is bigger than or equal to 1st of January. And then I'm going to type in and gender equals, wait, is gender capital? Gender equals female. Is that what I said? So if you run this, okay, if you run this, what happens is it'll list people who were born after 1st of January 2000 and the females. So I'm just gonna go back to the select query and include the gender column so you can see that it's right. Oops. View SQL. So yep, we're selecting the gender, their last name, first name, birthday. So if you run it, these people are born after 1st of January 2000 and their gender is female. Okay, now the second keyword I want to introduce you guys to is instead of and, let's change it to or. And the difference now is that now it's going to list all the people who were born after 1st of January as well as the people who are females. Not necessarily both. So if you run this query now, you will have people who were born after the 1st of January, and you also have people who are females. So basically you got two things. If they satisfy either of these conditions, so if they are born after this year, this day, or if they're females, they will all be part of the query. Whereas if you put and, what's going to happen is they will need to satisfy both of these conditions for the rows to be included. So now we're only going to get females who were born after the year 2000. So that's the difference between and or. So I encourage you try that. So now we got females as well as people who were born after the year 2000. So other than and or, I also want to introduce you guys to like. So let's say I want to list people whose names start with B. Okay, so I can go where name, first name, like, so it sort of means similar to starting with B and asterisks. Asterisks just means that it can have anything after the character B. So if you run this, it only lists Brian. Because Brian starts with B, obviously. So that's when you would use the like keyword. So let's try starting with J. So go back to SQL, like J star. And let's run it. And I get John, Joyce, Jim, Joey, a lot of students. Okay, I guess that's enough for one tutorial. We're gonna do more on this on the next lesson. Thanks for watching. See you next time.